Pat Supreme here with this week's Reset for Life moment. I don't know about you, but there are times in my life that I get so comfortable with things that I take those things for granted. Especially as a child, for instance, I can remember having like these crazy moments where I would get all caught up in my feelings and say to my parents stuff like, "You guys don't do anything for me." And my mom was like, "Oh yeah? So I guess we've been living on the street because we haven't put shelter over your head. And I guess I'm seeing things because I'm pretty sure that you have clothes on right now. But that wouldn't be possible if we haven't done anything for you, because that would mean that we haven't bought you any clothes. Or you must be starving because we haven't given you any food. But I'm pretty sure I watched you eat breakfast that I cooked. And I thought I packed you a lunch, and I'm pretty sure I can smell food cooking on the stove right now, but I must be mistaken because we haven't done anything for you." She would say stuff like that, and it would get me so mad. But here's the thing about it. She was right. The things that she was doing for me was major and were the things that I absolutely needed. But what I was looking for was things that in the grand scheme of things were small. We often do the same thing with God. We get so caught up in the things that we don't have rather than focusing on the one thing that matters that we do have. If we've chosen to repent and make Jesus the Lord of our lives, we get salvation. None of us deserve it, but He decided to give us the opportunity to receive it. And as believers, even when we know we have it, we often take it for granted. It's like it's not even a big deal anymore sometimes. And so I think we get to this place where we recognize that we have this thing, but we don't realize that it's not something that we absolutely deserve. Then we actually, what we do deserve was to be damned to hell. We don't like talking about that anymore, but it's true. Listen to what Paul says in Ephesians chapter 2, starting at verse 1. "And you were dead in the trespasses and sins in which you once walked, following the course of this world, following the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work in the sons of disobedience." We like to forget who we were, but we all are guilty and we all deserve hell. We all deserve to be sentenced to hell. Again, we don't like to say that, but we all deserve to be sentenced to hell. And maybe for some of you hearing that, you're saying, "Well, that's not me," but listen to what it says at verse 3. "Among whom we all once lived in the passions of our flesh, carrying out the desires of the body and the mind, and were by nature children of wrath like the rest of mankind." It says we all have lived desiring things that were not of God. Maybe you aren't right now, but at some point you did. And so again, we all deserve eternal punishment and hell. Now this may sound all doom and gloom, but here's the good part at verse 4. It says, But God being rich in mercy because of His great love with which He loved us, even when we were dead in our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved and raised up with Him and seated up with Him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, so that in the coming ages He may show the immeasurable riches of His grace and kindness towards us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not of your own doing, it is a gift from God." That right there is so good. I don't think I even need to speak on that anymore. So here's how I'm gonna end. So I just wanna remind you guys, let's not get crazy and focus on the little things that we don't have, which in the grand scheme of things doesn't really matter. And remember the greatest thing and the most important thing that we do have, and that is salvation through Christ Jesus. I'm Pastor Kareem, and this was this week's Reset for Life moment.